And now it's time to dish the dirt with your host, Dr. Sophia von Furstenberg, a professor of Lacanian symbolism specializing in meta-text linguistics, and Lisa Moon, an aesthetic psychologist and author of Bliss, The Social Frontiers of Window Design, and Uta Klench, the world's leading expert in performance deconstructionism. You're in the dirt, reporting on the world of design, movement, and fashion movement.
Hello, this is Sophia von Furstenberg.
I'm Annalisa Moon.
Uta Klench.
And we are
The Dirt.
Get in it, on it.
Take it in.
Kind of smudge it on your face and feel the nutrients soaking.
Come back at 5, 8, and 10 to get in The Dirt.
We're live backstage at the Mud Dome with famed designer Branimira Ivanova.
This is a very exciting sneak peek. Branimira, might we interrupt you for a moment? What was the inspiration behind the Wesu couture line?
Birds and Mudwoman. This jacket, since I'm working on her, it was larger ladies jacket, and then it's completely reworked.
Someone with a little more poop in their plumage.
The skirt she's wearing used to be bottom of a ball gown.
Oh, look at that.
Chanton, silk chanton, right?
That's mineral water or tap water?
Are you nervous at all about the upcoming fashion show?
It's an adrenaline rush, seeing your collection presented, unveiled in public.
Right, could you fix my zipper? Actually, this is going to go all the way up right here. Right, and now I can call this an exclusive Branimira Ivanova.
Right.
The dirt.
Branimira Ivanova's 2009 spring collection pulls inspiration from the backyard. Bird in bath.
Embodiment of clothing made from recycled materials, old ball gowns, wedding dresses, suit coats, and scraps of leather. A faded memory of color is the Wesu couture line by Branimira. Using Japanese fabric molding techniques on her many shades of muted gray, Miss Ivanova creates a montage of ferocious female inches.
Wesu is derived from the French word for bird. Striated caracara.
Lioness bitch.
History is Branimira's hand. The first dress mishmash marched a four-footed dress with an asymmetrical neckline and a flared hemline. The arms are attached at the waist. Fire orange chilling down in a cage of plum-cut in leather and lace.
The striated caracara is related to the prehistoric raptor and is a bird of prey.
Right, this is a breathless experimentation with fabric. It's shadows of occasions to lie.
Yes, it's before, reused, refits, regurgitated, reconstructed.
Exactly.
Crested petrol.
Oh, yes. A bandage bodice cascading into a bouffant sweep of tulle, bookending the Sydney Opera House-inspired dress of leather, metal, and plastic burning. Remembrances of a Sean Tom sports coat of the past? A beautiful, freestanding, and structural tripartite.
Now, what's really fascinating about the crested petrol and bluebird is that they turn bright purple during mating season. Yes, always. And it's also interesting because they were considered to be soul birds because they represented the souls of drowned sailors. So it was considered unlucky to touch them.
The cartography of the fabrics here is simply topographical.
Topographical.
How are you? It's a skeleton of tulle, buckles, and a garland of fabric that creates this magical birdcage. An x-ray of poof, cross-cinched at the waist, with a mesh-like collar, hood of tulle and wool.
You know, the Hiberu is from Paraguay and stands for bird in ancient Egyptian hieroglyphics.
Except that this bird is the real thing!
Exciting! Yes, it's fierce. It's wonderful to see such a high-energy collection harkening back to the playfulness of fashion and color.
It's paleolithic, harkening back to our connection with the earth.
I'll be your noise. This shit will fuck you up.
Way egret.
The farm is nighttime dress-up.
with muted steel highlights reminiscent of the Indiana Mills. And if I was no shit of yours, just twist this cup of glamour and say, hold it! Freedom is the most important. To escape convention and to allow women to wear what makes them feel beautiful. At the turn of the century, fashion demanded massive amounts of ego bloom for hats and breeding modes were killed, causing some of the ego species to become endangered by relentless hunting. What is this here? The fabric is just so liquid and it's almost too good for the body.
Cormorant.
The cormorant is the long-legged contradiction derived from the Latin for morinus, which stands for sea raven. It's mud. It's dirty. And it's fighting the conventional norms for what it means to be clean. It's a fashion revolution. It's a revolutionary costume beyond the revolutionary formula. It's fiercely fierce. Inspired exploration. Then let's talk about the makeup for a moment. Don't be modest. Look amazing. Oh, true. Mud is the new Brazilian wear. And feathers. Feathers are the new fur. It's the manicure of the new millennium.
Oh, the new millennium is so 10 years ago.
The new mud's a little
now the monkey walking before. The woman that inspired it all. Mudwoman, the ultimate fashion maven.
I've been waiting all season for this outfit.
Yeah, oh, this is going to be really exciting.
The Imperial Hudson.
Imperial Mudwoman. The Grand Diva Fiercest is wearing a ruffle and rouge halter top and hood of crested plumage. This once-worn, once-wine-stained, broken-zippered bridesmaid gown has been transformed into a wearable work of art! I would call it the double-tiered, high-waisted, fiercely frosted fashion cake!
No, no. The top bride meets Cinderella! Ooh. The swirling skirt is indicative of Atalee Judy's Japanese folding technique.
So true, and then she just, you know, sews it all to hell.
Which translates as basing it into sea of stitches.
That's right, well put.
Oh, no, I love this.
Very good. Come on, now. This is amazing. It's another wonderful collection from Branimira. And doesn't my woman's eyes grow inspiring in that gown?
Yes, they're falling in tigers.
Feathers of the new black. Ooh, look at that. Awesome. You have a little mind sitting there.
Oh, so nice.
Swirl it, honey.
I think I've been myself.
Happiness surely has a wing upon a girl like Grace and Madwoman.
Atalee's body is clearly more in line with the nested roundedness of Mudwoman's physique.
Ladies, let's not count all of our eggs just yet.
Clearly put her in front of her back. She's Atalee, one of the fear-required storm of tension.
When is the last time a fashion show ended in a beauty bar for the Mud Queen?
This was just a shame.
So true. Shame. I was at the Ren Faire last week and it was nothing like that.
Please welcome the host of The Dirt, Dr. Sophia.
Oh, I love that shot of you.
You look how fresh and new you are, darling.
Okay, can we roll the clip?
Right, yes.
Cue up tape at 2:37 and roll tape. Go.
We're going to take another glance at that instant bout of beauty in the mud.
What is this one?
Okay. Look, she's supinated on her 8 inches, yes. Almost falling off the edge. That could have meant losing this battle, but she saves it.
Her strength saved it.
Her strength and character, will, and ankles.
This next shot just might bend the pivotal move that sunk this great battleship.
Oh, we really didn't know who had this until the very end.
B12.
But Atalee just could not hold on to her title.
D12.
Oh, you said
let's go backstage and
let's go.
Interview with my woman,
yes.
Exclusives.
Let's go, darling. Let's get it.
Oh, my dear.
This is Sophia von Furstenberg live at the Mud Dome with exclusive coverage with Mud Woman, fashion muse Maven Moltrix, the most multifarious mesomorph to hit the scene in over 10 years. So Mud Woman, what's with the mud?
Okay, so it's the connection with the earth. It's all about the chakra energy, and I believe that's the first chakra.
Yes, right. Mud Woman, where were you born?
Usula.
Georgia. And then you moved to Dubai. Fascinating. And now you live in France in a geodesic dome.
So, Mud Woman, tell me, when exactly did you start with the mud? I mean, I hear that it's cool and it's hot and it's also very good for your skin, is it not?
That reminds me how the body mugs the earth and the earth mugs the body. It reminds me of that famous Cuban artist, Ana Mendieta. Do you know her work? Well, she would mark the body in the mud.
What is it that you are looking for at this... So you wanna be a Mud Woman backup dancer? 2008 audition. What type of dancer? Yes, you want their actions to be spontaneous and raw from the molten core of their soul.
Yes, like that improv I saw at the Living Theater in 1967 when they were all naked in the basement of that church and pissing on one another.
I think that maybe we should give Mud Woman a moment to get ready for the So You Wanna Be a Mud Woman Fly Dancer Audition 2008, because there are a lot of dancers out there, so we should probably join them.
That was The Dirt.
Coming up next, The Dirt gets dirtier as Uta Glench deconstructs the performative rise of our Mud Diva's career.
Wanna Be a Mud Woman Backup Dancer Audition 2008. Group B to the stage. Repeat, dancers 1 through 10 to the stage.
Fabulous. It looks like Mud Woman is going to be making her first round cards. Numbers 3, 8, and 10. You go.
All right, let's take it from the top. And for the rest of you, in order to be a Mud Woman dancer, you need to be fierce. Yes. Show us what you've got. You're having about as much grace as a flamingo right now.
Ooh!
you're too the tall, skinny one in the front, yes you. Can you get lower in your squat? Right, and arch your back more.
And don't forget to choreography at the same time. You can multitask
it. Keep it together.
Okay, more energy, people. Be the tiger.
Right. Remember there are counts to this and they're not in Swedish. 5, 6, 7, 8.
These moves be cliche like on a YouTube video.
Oh, 6, when you shake your tail feathers, could you shake them as if they were an instant Polaroid photograph?
Oh,
yeah. Oh, much better. There you go. Come on, ride the horse, not the CTA.
A little more sexiness.
Oh, no.
Yes, I know.
Your arm is at the wrong angle.
Yes, you just fix it. Just fix it.
Oh, it's at the wrong angle. A little higher, yeah. No, actually a little lower.
Right.
Right there. That's the one to remember.
Okay, we just take it from the top. And this time, can you be a little less suburban?
Oh, a little more yin, a little less yang.
No one likes an aggressive girl.
Well, some people do, darling.
Well, yes, that's true. But not when it comes to...
No.
Just
not for this. Not for the back of death.
Remember the good old days when they used to smile?
I liked Thursdays.
Oh, see, now that's about it.
Yes, they clearly just don't want it badly.
I mean, it's a little too punchy, I think. Remember, this is not some sort of industrial rave, people. Drop the glow sticks.
What is this?
I don't think these dancers can really dance.
What is
I don't know what that is. I mean,
it's interesting.
That's just rot.
Sensorial.
Mudwoman, darling, I have an exclusive interview with your new backup dancers. Please.
Oh my God, I'm trapped.
And now the host of The Dirt, Dr. Sophia von Furstenberg, Annalisa Moon, and Uta Glench.
Mudwoman, your new backup dancers seem to be dancing better than you. You must admit, their moves are tighter.
Have you reached your peak?
I heard that you suffered a broken toenail before the performance. Did that affect how you did tonight?
Are you seeking medical attention?
Are you taking prescription painkillers?
I'm on Xanax. There is nothing to be afraid of.
I've tried acupuncture. I mean, that might work for you.
Is that house in France your retirement home?
I think Mudwoman needs to be left alone right now.
Because the world owes me
nothing, and we owe each other the world. And I do it 'cause it's the least I can do. I do it because I've learned it from you. And I do it just because I want to. Yeah, I want to.
Do that.
I know. Did you two both feel that?
I mean, how did she do that section with her eyes closed? It must have been a totally different experience.
Yeah, I mean, imagine how vulnerable that makes you feel.
It was an obvious Lacanian reference, the mere image of self as other.
No, it was more than that. I mean, she was really exposing herself in a fierce
She
way.
Certainly was exposing herself, darling.
What I'm saying is that that's risky and rare for an artist to do.
Did you not notice all those sapphic embraces?
Oh, good God. Sophia, would you get your nose out of the school books for like 3 minutes?
Somebody must bring some legitimacy to critical analysis.
Which is what I am trying to do by expressing just how she really brought something out that I haven't seen before. You know what? Like,
did you just shush me?
Is that a man?
Oh, my God. Sign.
Look, we have a point to make, and we were just discussing the piece at hand, and...
Please.
He's mad woman. And it looks like, yes,
she's sniffing out for the perfect truffle.
Thank you. sad day. Sad, very sad, sort of needing a pill. Maybe a couple pills. Maybe the whole bottle of pills. Glass of water, anyone, for that bottle of pills would really help. Very, very, very depressed. Oh, and upset again. Upset and frustrated. So frustrated. Oh, and more frustrated than before. Oh, yeah. Getting really tired of the whole situation. Yep, that's right. Let it out. Get it all out. We're only in the middle of a performance. Come on, let it out. Get it all out. We're all waiting. This for you.
Did you feel that one?
I need a break after that. As a matter of fact, I need a drink. And good thing for us, they have them here at the Viaduct.
Hey, you know, I hear they're like voted the best.
And dancers, this is your 15-minute call. Tech crew sweep floor in 5. I'm going to go for a smoke.
Make sure that you're 15 feet from the building.
I'm getting closer.
the savage beauty in that piece was like watching the tension between rams when they charge head to head, locking mantles and dueling for territory. Or like when the lion chases after the zebra. It's oh so brutal, I can't look away. I can't not look away.
Biosemiotics. It's the study of the production, action, and interpretation of signs in the biological realm. By describing the continuity between body and mind, biosemiotics may help us to understand how human-mindedness may more naturalistically emerge from the more primitive processes of embodied animal knowing.
Like when the crocodile lunges out of the water and clamps down onto the leg of a gazelle. It's nature being...
natural. Except that it's not really about the brutality, it's more about the emotional intensity and the physicality. I mean, it's so exciting, it makes you want to jump out of your seat and just join in the chaos, am I right? I mean, that guy wants to do it, I can tell.
Stay tuned, you won't believe what's coming up next.
Does something seem different to you about Mudwoman?
Oh, yes. I have not seen such an array of emotions from her in a long
time. You mean since the height of her career, when she was really on the top of her game?
You mean when she was sans mode?
Don't say it.
The mud is what made her.
Or was it just a cover?
That was funny.
And we're on in 5, 4, 3.
More dishing the dirt.
What kind of rocks do you think those are? Marble, granite, limestone, really?
Oh my god, do you see that thing? It's like something out of a Pink Floyd video. Okay, all right, we're all panicked, but it is in your hair.
As Dr. Sophia Van Furst discusses causality of biosymbiotics and evolution.
Oh my god! Oh no, it's by that audience member over there. Right over there. I'm sorry, I'm in your chair.
Yeah.
level. Level.
Thank you.
inside. She breaks free from the chrysalis and greets the world anew. Oh, I'm sorry, so sorry. Really, I really felt something there. I mean, I get it. I get it now. Could we just talk about it for a moment? Oh, wait, I get it. Really, I do. I get it, darlings.
All right, people, that's a wrap. And credits and cue, go. Thank you.